change managers.
Oh, good. Okay, I'll start over then.
Seriously. The camera club's meeting almost daily. I think they'd like you.
All right.
Thank you.
Hey, introduce
him. Judge, I'm first term judge of 23.
Just step over on the side. They don't do you. Thank you.
Admiral Hernandez?
Yes, Mr. President. Thank you. I'm very pleased. My honor. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Rita Moreno.
Yes, hello.
How are you? Terrific. Thank you. And how nice of you to take the time to see us.
Oh, listen.
We're most grateful. Thank you.
Mr. Ray Pagan?
Mr. President, nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Chancellor Nathan Quinones?
Mr. President, hello. You want us individually introduced?
No. Thank you so much for having us.
Pleased to have you here.
We're thinking about your health.
Thank you.
And Dr. Ramirez, the Commissioner of Mental Health.
Thank you for having us here.
Well, I'm very appreciative of all that you've done. I want to congratulate all of you on the awards that you've received. I think they're going to want us here in a group.
Should we go to where you are?
I think we ought to kind of split up.
Come down here.
Spread around.
Last time I saw you was at dinner at 14:05.
Yes.
We were doing the Odd Couple at the National Theater.
Yes.
Step back a little bit.
So much for the community. And the community is also made a contribution to arts and education and everything else.
So what's so wonderful is that it's just been such a long time since Hispanic, particularly Puerto Rican people, have been so recognized, and we're really very, very thrilled to have you acknowledge that recognition for the National Puerto Rican Coalition. It makes us feel very good and very important.
The highlight of the awards meeting with you, Mr. President. We just had a wonderful luncheon.
Well, that's great.
And a reception on the Hill later this afternoon, so it's going to be a good day for the awards.
Our people will be very proud of this.
We do lose some of our
teachers. Thank you very much.
Great pleasure.
Yes, sir.
Puerto Rico. Sally Jesse Raphael.
Yes,
hi. Monica Thompson.
Hello.
Chair of the National Puerto Rican Coalition.
Thank you for having us.
Mr. Walcott.
Johnson and Johnson.
Hello.
G. Van Vechten, who helped to bring all this about.
Rita, you know, and you all know that, of course, coming from California, why Hispanic culture and the Hispanic language and all is have a great affection and affinity for it. I should leave off that word language. Some years ago, before I was here, the then president asked me as governor to represent him in an affair in Mexico. And in Mexico City, I spoke on his behalf and sat down to very scattered and I was a little embarrassed. More so when the man that followed me got up speaking in Spanish, which I didn't understand, but he was being interrupted about every second or third sentence with the warning. So to hide my embarrassment when they were louder than anything, that our ambassador leaned over and whispered to me, he said, I wouldn't do that if I were you. And I said, well, why? And he said, he's interpreting your speech. These are key rings with the presidential seal.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Just thought as a little souvenir of your visit here would.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you.
I hope I've got it right.
Nice thing to have.
Thank you, sir.
You know, that's great.
Thank you very much.
That's wonderful.
Did I miss someone?
We had...
I guess I had one extra then.
That's lovely.
That little seal that's on there, I have you notice there's a little history, interesting history with that. That seal on the desk has been there many years, goes way back. And this one is more modern. But that one, the eagle, is turned looking at the arrows.
It's
old. Now the eagle is looking at the olive branch. Harry Truman did that after the war.
Bless his heart.
Wonderful. Mr. President, I did want to just say very quickly that you do us honor in receiving these Life Achievement Awardees, because I believe, and I've been in Washington for the last 20 years, this is, I think, the first time that a group of Puerto Rican achievers have met with the President on this exclusive basis. And I really appreciate your endorsement of this program.
I'm very proud to be the first then.
May I say something also? I would like to remind you that there are many Hispanics in this country who are in the process of achieving what these amazing people have achieved, not just Puerto Ricans, but Hispanics, many who aspire to achieve what these wonderful people have achieved. And I hope you, as the president with an enormous amount of clout and power, will look favorably upon the Hispanic community and see if you can help us out in any way you can.
I shall be more than happy to do that.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Lisa, I can tell you, and I'm not just speaking politically or not, this is a subject that we have kept in mind in regard to appointments and so forth, and gone out of our way because we felt that there was more of a role for our Hispanic community than they had been receiving.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. I want to do one more quick photo with everyone now since we've got sponsors and everyone together.
You believe in yourself,
right?
Why don't we show these because they're so beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah,
that was beautiful.
Can
I
have
too
much time, please?
Can
everybody move in a little bit?
I just want to cover you.
No,
I'm looking at you. Yeah, but I'm smaller than
mine.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm Nancy. I refer to her now and then as a Pee Wee Power.
Oh, yes. You have to look out for the little ones. We are little, but our mouths are very large. Look at sister.
Regards to this, she has been very supportive of work with addiction, with which I have somehow related.
Yes.
Phoenix House. So
yes, this is the gentleman who originated Phoenix House, Dr. Ramirez.
Yes. I'm very pleased with her for her support. Please convey our
well. I certainly shall. Michelle,
thank you again.
So well, and congratulations.
Adios.
Adios.
Hasta pronto. Until soon. Until the next time.
But I can say bye and good deals.
Good.
Again, Mr. President.
President, thank you. We got to pull something out of the latest problem in the education.
Yes. All right.
Thank you so much.
You.
Thank you, Mr. President. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Terry.
Thank you. Thank you. Pleased to have you here.
Thank you for your time.
Really? Thank you very much.
I'm sorry.
No. Thank you for your time.
They've asked to restage it. So.
Yeah,
this one I missed.
Missed the handshake on the way in.
Great honor. Thank you. God bless you, sir.
Rudy just came on. He wasn't here when you did the Office of Public Liaison.
I missed step.
Oh, well.
Thank you, sir.
You bet.
All right.
Thanks.
Two kids in the same family, in your apartment.
You did?
Totally. So I proved I've never understood that.
Why? This is my mother, Helen.
Hello, Mary. Good to see you.
My sister, Helen.
Hello.
My surrogate son, actually, my nephew, Eric.
How are you?
And my brother, Bob.
Hi, Lisa.
My father, Robert.
Hello.
Robert, sir.
And my mom, Christina.
So you and I will go over here in front of the fireplace, and then you will all join us in a few minutes.
Citation to accompany the award of the Defense Superior Service Medal to Lieutenant Commander Vivian S. Cray, United States Coast Guard. Lieutenant Commander Vivian S. Cray, United States Coast Guard, distinguished herself by exceptionally superior service as Coast Guard aide to the President from October 1984 to August 1987. Commander Cray continually displayed superior leadership, exemplary foresight, and tireless effort, which were of paramount importance to the President and the nation. In this highly visible position, she routinely planned and coordinated numerous events of national and international significance. Her role as the Emergency Action Officer for presidential travel was accomplished with expertise and professionalism. Commander Cray served as the White House agent responsible for supervising the use of Department of Defense resources, supporting Commander-in-Chief travel throughout the world. Her performance as military coordinator for the 1986 Japan Economic Summit and the President's Far East visit was particularly noteworthy and contributed immeasurably to the Office of the President and the effectiveness of the White House Military Office. The distinctive accomplishments of Lieutenant Commander Cray reflect great credit upon herself, the United States Coast Guard, and the Department of Defense.
Thank you, sir. They're a little tricky sometimes.
There.
They're great.
All right. Well, thank you, listen, thank you for everything. And you put it at it and you learned to ride a horse.
Well, take the opportunity to thank you very much. It's been a complete honor. It's
well,
really a rare privilege.
Well, thank you, and we're going to miss you.
As a commander-in-chief and as an individual, you've been a great privilege.
Thank you. Now, won't you all come in and join us here? Maybe somebody on the other side.
We have to balance now about Christina and Eric. Right here. Excuse me. Right line.
The first woman to ever serve in this capacity. And she's been everything that he read about.
Didn't fall off?
No. All right. Well.
Thank you. Have a nice vacation.
Thank you. Yeah, we'll be going. We'll miss you.
I know.
Mr. President, we decided
It would be important for us to all be in the proper uniform.
So you've got to come in with us. Mine's gotten much smaller.
Ours is too big.
Okay. I don't know if I can do this.
We're all going to cry when this is off in a real picture.
There they come. You leave, I'm going over to the doctor, he's going to take mine.
It's obvious Dr. Hudson didn't put theirs on.
That's true. Well, he now takes mine off at the end of the afternoon, and then I go without it through the night, and then put it on again in the morning. But there's the possibility today that they're going to take the stitches out. Yeah, they've taken eight of them out. About 11 to go. I'm hoping.
That's okay.
Smile, Wayne. Thank you.
Well, my favorite picture's going to be the one before you do. All right. Well, again.
Yes, sir.
Bye and good luck. Thank you, sir. Gentlemen.